Appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises COSASE, officials of the National Water and Sewerage Corporation decried non-payment of water bills by government ministries, departments and agencies. The National Water and Sewerage Corporation demands public institutions over 70 billion in accrued arrears.
As Minister of Defense, 27.4 billion. Uganda Police, 23.3 billion. Prisons, 11.8 billion. Then hospitals, 6.9, that's about 7 billion. And then, of course, there's the others in millions. Embassies, you said how much? These are not even numbers.
Embassies are not under the ministry.
Embassies, are they standalone? Yeah.
They are standalone.
Yeah. It's not indicated here.
They are not ministries, sir.
Where
are the embassies?
Silva Macha, the managing director of the National Water and Sewerage Corporation, told COSASE that the entity is choking on debt of water bills arrears amounting to 175 billion in total, of which 70.6 billion is a debt which government agencies owe the entity. The debt by the government agencies dates back to 13 and a half months ago, which has frustrated operations of the corporation.
On water bills.
Water and sewerage.
It was 159, it is now 175. And this 175, this is how it is structured. The commercial category is 29 billion. The domestic is 63 billion. The embassies is 219 million. Industrial is 1.6 billion.
The lead debtors include the Ministry of Defense at 27.4 billion shillings, Uganda Police Force 23.3 billion, and prisons 11.8 billion. Others are State House, which owes 45.4 million. Courts of Judicature, 383 million, DPP, 1.8 million, hospitals, 7 billion, among other agencies. MPs wondered why government agencies accumulate arrears on water bills, yet they are appropriated money in their budgets every financial year to cater for water expenses.
Minister of Defense, 27.5 billion.
Come again?
27.5 billion.
That's Minister of Defense.
Minister of Defense.
27.5 billion.
Minister of Energy, 176.6 million.
We get the list. I'm having reliable information that even among the debtors, State House is among. So my concern is that, yes, and every time they are asking for supplementary. My biggest concern is maybe doctor is protecting the image of the state. Otherwise, there are no reasons to why we cannot be furnished with the list of debtors, even if State House is there. This average rate of recovery is going to make us hide those who have been accumulating bills for many years. So my request is that for these specific big bills, let's get the specifics. For how many years has this bill accumulated? So that when we are advising, we advise when we are handling specific areas. Otherwise, the average rate will cover up even those who are defaulting for many years.
Mujisha told the committee that most ministries budget for fewer funds for water and sanitation utility bills, which can't do much to meet the demand.
Ministries do not budget enough to cater for all the what? All the bills. And that's the request we can also put to you as members of this committee.
Lead setters wondered why the agency is quick to disconnect other Ugandans with small arrears while giving a blind eye to government agencies that have accrued huge amounts.
What is National Water doing to recover this money? Or are you saying we have given up? Meanwhile, you continue to supply services.
Is it in order for a senior council to say that National Water has been using barbaric means of cutting peasants and leaving the ones we think they are doing well to stay with water?
COSACE demanded National Water to provide a list of all defaulting government agencies, embassies and other organizations with details of the age of their debts. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.